Good morning, friend. Today we want to start from chapter 9, that is applications, or we can say height and distance. In this chapter, we first go through concept, that is use, where we have to use in height and distance, that is measure of length, height, width of river, and angle, and inaccessible, that we cannot image it. Inaccessible means हम लोग जिसको measure नहीं कर सकते ऐसा length जो हमारे concept में भी नहीं देता. So, first the important term related with angle of elevation, angle of depression. Angle of elevation. In this angle, it is the angle. So, angle of elevation. So, one person is standing at here and it is a horizontal level. If I will see upward side, agar hum log upar dekhenge, it is the angle formed by the line of sight with the horizontal when it is above the horizontal level. So an object is above the horizontal level in case we raise our head to look an object. That is called angle of elevation. Our head to look at the object, that is called angle of elevation, or we can say E also. So horizontal level, line of sight. So generally, it's again make a right angle triangle, that is A, B, and C. So here it is theta, angle of elevation. So maybe possible it is a building, tower. Here it is a distance. So name of chapter is also height and distance. Height and distance. Name of this chapter is also called height and distance. So now we go for the different term. So first angle of elevation, single of angle of depression. In case when we lower our head to look at the object, when we lower our head to look at the object, we can say angle of depression. Generally what happened, here it is an object. So maybe possible person is on the height of tower. So it is a tower. Now what happen if I join this again right angle triangle? Now here it is Z. We can say it is Z. So whatever angle A is at here, that is angle A is at also here. But important is to lower our head, look at the object. We can say angle of depression. So this is a recent example related to your text. That is, to establish the height of building, a person walk 120 feet away from the building. So there is a one building. At that point, an angle of elevation is 30. So here it is a 30 degree. He is from looking at the top of a building. Find the height of building. Or here it is a building, but one temple is there. So find the height of temple. So again it is a right angle triangle. When right angle triangle is there, again A, B, C. Here it is 30 degree and here it is 120. So we can say it is X. Mostly in height and distance we are using TOA, that is 10 theta is equal to opposite upon adjacent. 10 theta is equal to opposite upon adjacent. Mostly we have to use when we have to find either height or either distance. Again, different way height is there. We can, an observer on the top of hill measure an angle of depression 60 degree when looking at the truck parked in the valley below. If the truck is 55 feet from the base of the hill, how hill is the base? Again, here it is x. Again, it is a right angle triangle if you will see properly. So here, when here it is 60 degree, again you can make 60 degree at here. Why? Because alternate angle is here. So here it is 60 degree, so we can put 60 degree also here. So now here 60 degree we can put. So tan 60 is equal to height upon 55. Because we know that we have to use the TOA. So tan theta is equal to opposite upon adjacent. So that way we can find out the height, that is 95. So we can, in surveying, we can find out the width of the river. Here it is called length, but we can find out the width of the river by using trigonometric functions. So again, here one example is there. So it's a river, one person is at here. And here it is a 30 degree. Here it is x, and here it is given 70 feet. Or we can say breadth. So we can say x. So again, right angle triangle. Again, right angle triangle is there. Here we can say 30 degree. Here we can say x. Here we can say 70. So now tan 30 is equal to x upon 70. Value of tan 30, and by using, we can get approximately, that is 40.41. Clinometer. It is an instrument which is used to measure the height of distance object using trigonometric concept. So to find out the height, always one formula, that is h tan theta into x means distance, x is a unit and theta is an angle related with it. So clinometer is an instrument which is used to measure the height of distance object using trigonometric concept. So tan theta means what? Opposite upon hypotenuse, opposite upon adjacent. And sorry, we have to use the degree 30. Now it is your, according to text, great trigonometric survey of the British India, for which two largest over theodolites, each one of the instrument, which used to find out the height of Mount Everest. During the survey in 1852, the highest mountain in the world was discovered. From a distance of over 160 km, peak was observed from six different stations. In 1856, this peak was named by Sir George Everest. Mount Everest is named on the person who find out the height of Mount Everest first time, who had commissioned and the first used the giant theodolite. The theodolites are now on display of Museum of Survey of India in Dehradun. So that is also a use of trigonometry. Now we go for example one that is given in question. Always draw the figure or diagram. Always remember or draw the figure. So a tower stands vertically on the ground. From a point on the ground, so point on the ground, so we can say like that. A tower stands vertically on the ground. From a point on the ground is 15 meter away. So here it is 15 meter away. Always one right angle triangle we have to do. Always name in triangle ABC, measure angle B is equal to 90 degree. Angle of elevation of the top of tower is found to be 60. So here we have to write. So don't do like that. We have to draw the correct figure is like. Now always use, here it is a height. So we have to use the function tan theta is equal to opposite upon adjacent. So by using 1060, we have to write root 3 AB upon 15. So AB is equal to 5 root 3. Now if value of root 3 is given, 1.71, then we can find out correct height. Otherwise, you have to write the answer like that. That is, height of tower is 15√3. So these are all the example in text. Only one exercise is there in our book. Only one exercise there. According to the board rules, only 6 or 7 sums from this exercise we have to do. One more example is there. An electrician has to repair an electrical fault on a pole of height 5 meter. So, हमारे घर के बाहर जो इलेक्ट्रिकल पोल रहते हैं वो टोटल हाइट अप्रोक्सीमेटली कितना रहता है 5 मीटर. She need to reach 1.3 मीटर बिलो द टॉप. सो फ्रॉम हियर वी हैव टू दैट इज 1.3. सो इट मींस हियर इट इज 1.7. सो BD इज इक्वल टू 3.7 सॉरी. So, height, that is 3.7. So, first of all, we draw one rough triangle, right angle triangle. That is, you have to B, D, C. Here already we get 3.7. Now, question is, what should be the length of the ladder? So, here we have to find out. And also, how far from the foot of the pole should she place the foot of ladder? So, distance also we have to find out. So, when hypotenuse is there, we have to use the function sine. Soch. Soch is equal to sine theta is equal to opposite upon hypotenuse. So, we can use sine 60 degree. Sine 60 degree is equal to BD upon BC. So value of BD, that is 3.7, BC sine 60 root 3 by 2. If we do cross multiplication, BC is equal to 3.7 into 2 divided by root 3. But value of root 3 is given 1.73. So we can put this and we can get value 4.2 meter. When root 3 is there, always write the answer in bracket approximately. Now here find the ladder by. So we can also use 10, we can also use quarter. Because 3.7 already we have, and if I want to find out this, and here it is theta, so we can use 10 theta also. So 10 60 degree is equal to 3.7 upon x. 10 60 value we know root 3. So root 3 is equal to 3.7 into x. So we can also by this method. Answer is same, but approximately you have to write. Why? Because you have to write it approximately. When root 3 value we are used, you have to write the answer in approximately. So we can use 10 theta, we can use sine theta, we can use cos theta, we can use cot theta, all four functions we can use. Example 3. An observer 1.5 meter tall is 28.5 meter. An observer 1.5 meter tall, so one person is there whose height is 1.5 meter. Is 28.5 meter away from a chimney, so it is a distance. That is 28.5 meter. Angle of
updates have been applied.
Angle of elevation of the top of chimney from her eye is 45 degrees. So here it is 45. So actually is like that. Here it is 28.5. Here it is 45 degree. We have to find out the height of chimney. So when 10 45 is there, always remember when here it is 45, A, B, C. When 10 45 is there, always AB upon BC. Sorry, BC upon AB. Both are same. Value of 145 is 1. So x, if here it is x, we can get same answer x. Now we want to go 10:45, that is AE. Here if you will see the triangle, or we go over here. So here it is 45 degree. Now 45 degree AE, that is AE upon DE, that is 28.5. So again here 28.5. But question is, what is the height of chimney? So again 1.5, that is the height of observed, it should be added. That is why height of chimney is 30 meter. Now I think 1, 2 and 3 example we have completed. So now we have to start exercise 9.1. So exercise 9.1, before we start it, we have to read the question. A circus artist is climbing a 20 meter long rope which is tied strange and tied from the top of vertical pole of the ground. Find the height of the pole if angle of made by the rope with the ground level is 30 degrees. So that is given. Now what is the find the height? So I have to write h at here. Now trigonometric function. So in the given figure, AB is pole, compulsory you have to write, and AC is a rope. In triangle ABC, AB upon AC is equal to, so such sin theta is equal to AB upon BC. So sin theta, that is 30. AB upon AC. So 30 is equal to H upon 20. Sin 30 value is 1 by 2 is equal to height upon 20. Cross multiplication, do it. Then 20 divided by 2, that is 10. You can get 10. So in the figure, AB is pole. The compulsory you have to write like that. AB is equal to 10. Hence the height of the pole is 10 meter. That is a correct answer. That way you have to do. Now one more question, that is 4. Angle of elevation of the top of tower from a point on the ground which is 30 meter away from the foot of tower is 30. Find the height of tower. Now when we are finding the height of tower and distance is given, we have to find out the height of tower and distance is given, we mostly use tan theta function. Height and distance relation is there. Height and distance relation is there. We have to use 10. Let AB is a tower and C is the point 30 meter away from the foot of tower in triangle ABC. Now AB upon BC is equal to 10:30. So AB upon 30 is equal to 1 upon root 3. We can go cross multiplication. Then AB is equal to 30 divided by root 3. But we cannot write root 3 as a denominator. We have to rationalize it. So we have to write that. So 30 root 3 by 3. We can cancel it. We can get answer 10 root 3. So 10 root 3 meter. It's a question number 4 and it is easy to solve. That is why from first I directly go through 4. Again, in first height is we have find, but according to the rope length. That is why we are using the sine function. While in fourth sum we have to find out the height, but here distance foot, that is given, distance given 30 meter. That is why we are using in question number 4, 10. That is important where we have to use 10 and where we have to use sine. So in question number 1, we are using sine, while in question number 2, we are using 10. Now question number 2. A tree break due to storm and the broken part bends so that the top of tree touches the ground, making an angle 30 degree with it. The distance between the foot of the tree to the point where the top touches the ground is 8 meter. Find the height of the tree. So you will see that is a one figure is there. AC is a tree which break at B. So from B here it is break, and broken part AB becomes A dash. So here A, it should be come at here, that A dash. So actually what happened, AB is equal to, we can write A dash B, both are same. Now question is, find the height of tower, find the height of tree. So again we have to use the tan function, that is TOA. That is tan theta is equal to opposite upon adjacent. So we can use BC upon A dash C. So here BC upon A dash C is equal to 1030. Value of 1030, that is 1 upon root 3. So if we will do cross multiplication, we can get first root 3 BC is equal to 8. So BC is equal to 8 upon root 3. We have to put as it is. So what we have to get value of BC, that is 8 upon root 3. Now I have to find out A dash B. To find A dash B, we have to use catch. Cos theta is equal to adjacent upon hypotenuse. So cos 30, adjacent, that is 8, upon A dash B, cos 30 root 3 by 2. So here they are writing A dash C upon A dash B is equal to cos 30. So 8 upon A dash B dash is equal to root 3 by 2. If we do cross multiplication, we can get A dash B dash is equal to 16 upon root 3. Now height of tree, first I rub everything. Now how to find height of tree, that is A dash B plus BC. So that is already we know 16 upon root 3 plus 8 upon root 3. So 24 upon root 3. Again rationalize it. That is 24 root 3 upon 3. 3 8. So 8 root 3. That is why your answer is 8 root 3. So 1, 2, 3, exercise 8.1, question 1, 2, 3 we have completed, example 1, 2 and 3, you have to complete in your fair book. Now also we have complete 4th sum, now we go for 3rd sum. A contractor planned to install two slides for the children to play in a park. For children below the age of 5 years, she preferred to have a slide whose top is at height 1.5 meter and is inclined at the angle of 30 degree to the ground. Whereas for elder children, she wants to have a steep slide at the height of 3 meter and incline at the angle of 60 degree to the ground. what should be the length of the slides in each case. So there are two children below 5 years, that is a slide. Children elder, that is a slide. Here angle is 30 degree. छोटे बच्चों के लिए एंगल कम रहता है, बड़ों बच्चों के लिए एंगल बड़ा रहता है. सो नाउ हाइट इज ऑल्सो कम रहता है, 1.5. हियर हाइट इज डबल, दैट इज 3. एंगल दैट इज 30 डिग्री, हियर इट इज 60. सो इफ यू विल सी दिस, वी कैन राइट वी व्हाट वी हैव टू फाइंड आउट लेंथ ऑफ द स्लाइड. सो हियर इट इज हाइपोटेन्यूज. To find hypotenuse, we are using sine function. So sine 30 degree is equal to u, we can AB upon AC. So sine 30, that is 1 by 2, 1.5 upon AC. Cross multiplication, we can get 3 meter. So for small children, that is below 5, the length is 3 meter. It should not more than 3 meter. Why? For elder children who are above 5 years, for elder, again I have to apply same, but here 60 is there, so sine 60 degree is there. Again that is a hypotenuse, and here it is a opposite. Again here it is opposite, and here it is adjacent. So sine 60 is equal to AB upon AC. So sine 60 we can say root 3 by 2 is equal to AB, that is here we can get answer, here it is 3 meter. So 3 upon AC. So if we cross multiplication, we can get 6 upon root 3. So AC is equal to 6 upon root 3, but we have to rationalize it. So that is 6 root 3 by 3, so we can cancel it, answer is 2 root 3. So if you will see properly, already solution is here. We have to compare the here it is a length is 2 root 3, it is larger because root 3 value is 1.73. So we have to multiply 2 with 1.73, we can get answer. So already we have completed 1, 2, 3, 4 some basic concept of height and distance. We have used angle of elevation, angle of depression. With example, we have also completed, that is example 1, 2, 3 and 4. Now in next slide, there are only 16 sums are there. So in next slide, we have to complete other 10 sums.